Well, we all know Google, Bing, and Yahoo. These are the three biggest and most popular search engines. But while they are popular, you may be looking for alternatives, maybe for privacy reasons, safe search, or something else. So in this video, you'll find 17 search engines other than Google, Bing, and Yahoo, and we have categorized them into the following. So sit tight, let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that empowers millions of WordPress sites with easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel empowers you with the right knowledge to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. So let's first check out some popular privacy-focused search engines. Let's start with Brave. More than just a privacy-focused search engine, Brave provides a browser that enhances the privacy of its users. And just like Firefox or Google Chrome, you can download and install the browser to your device to enhance the privacy of your web activities. And even in the Brave Search privacy notice, it says Brave Search is designed to be private by default. So you don't need to fiddle with complex settings to keep your data safe, and they give promises of never to track or learn anything about you. On their browser, you can click on the settings, you can change the language, open links in a new tab, select the light or dark theme. I personally like the dark theme. And as you expand the settings, you can choose the unit of measurement. In Singapore, we use kilograms, meters, and Celsius. You also have the option to select the level of safetiness of the search results. And also, you can select the country you are in to get local prioritized results. For example, if we select the United States and we search for breaking news, you will see this. But if I change the location to something else, let's say Taiwan, the results would have been different. Moreover, Brave pride themselves as not relying on big tech to produce the search results. They deliver the results based on their built from scratch index, so that the search results will not be biased. So Brave is an awesome search engine if privacy is your focus. The next privacy focused search engine is DuckDuckGo. Similar to Brave, it does not track users or their search history. According to them, there are data sources that support the search results come from specialized sources like SportsRadar and crowdsourced sites like Wikipedia, Bing, and many indexes. And they maintain their own web crawler as well, called DuckDuckBot. And because they aggregate data sources from various pre-anonymized sources, the search results can avoid being biased on anyone's search engine's algorithm or partnerships. And one of the things you can do if you don't like to see ads on the search results is to go to their settings. As you can see, there are many options for you to choose. And right here, under advertisements, you can turn it off. There are several privacy settings as well, should you wish to adjust them. Another thing to add is their bangs feature, which are shortcuts that will take you to the search results on other sites. For example, exclamation W and a search term WordPress will bring you directly to the page in Wikipedia about WordPress. If we change it to exclamation R, it means you want to search for something in Reddit. If we add Singapore, it will bring us directly to Reddit search results with a search term already in place. There are many sites that has this bangs feature. You can check out this page, scroll to the bottom, and start searching for a site. And here are some of the sites. There are a total of 900 sites that have this bangs feature. Anyway, if privacy is what you are after, then DuckDuckGo is for you. And to add another layer of privacy, install the DuckDuckGo browser. Startpage is another privacy-focused search engine. But instead of a privatized search index like Brave or an aggregation of hundreds of data sources, Startpage offers search results from Google, but with privacy. According to them, your personal data, search history, and IP address are not collected when searching for something on Startpage. To achieve that, they explain the process of separating and deleting your data at every step of your search activity. It does serve ads as well, but the ads are relevant to the search term rather than your browsing history. For example, if we search for best WordPress plugins, the ads served are related to the search term, as you can see. So if you're comfortable with the search results from Google but are concerned with your privacy, then Startpage offers a unique solution for you, as it is also compliant with the privacy laws and regulation of the EU, including the GDPR. But of course, use Startpage on either the Chrome incognito mode or on privacy-focused browsers like Brave or DuckDuckGo. Otherwise, it defeats the purpose of mitigating privacy issues. Our final privacy-focused search engine on the list is Swisscal. It is hosted in Switzerland, a country with strong privacy laws. They pride themselves on operating a search engine without data storage, which means they don't collect any of your information in the first place, and thus respecting your privacy. Swisscals do not have their own search index, so they are working with Bing to support their search results. It says it is a family-friendly search engine. However, you need to know that it only removes explicit and adult content, but it does not censor violent content. I've tried some searches, you can try it yourself. Overall, if you are looking for a privacy-focused search engine and you are comfortable with Bing's search results, Swisscal could be a good option for you. Next, let's talk about the popular search engines around the world. First is Yandex. It is a popular search engine in Russia. As Yandex evolves, it employs sophisticated machine learning algorithms to tailor search results to its users' needs, much like Google's RankBrain. And whenever we talk about tailoring and customizing to users' needs, it comes with collecting user data and search behavior. Yandex operates under the Russian data protection regulations, which differs from Google and other US-based companies, and users from different countries will be subjected to different applicable laws. So if privacy is your concern, then you may want to read Yandex's privacy policy before you use the search engine. And if you are traveling to Russia, it will be helpful if you use Yandex Maps to search for the best restaurants or whatever. It will provide much better results than other search engines. If you want to browse products sold in Russia, you can check out Yandex Market. It also has Yandex Music, Yandex Taxi to help you book a cab in Russia, and many others. And what I love most about the search engine is their image search. It has one of the best user interface. You can filter the images by size, by orientation, and even color. Plus, as an SEO, if you want to rank any sites on Yandex, it provides you with its very own webmaster tools, similar to the Google Search Console. So Yandex, although it is a popular search engine among Russians, anyone in the world can utilize its features if they want to. Next is Naver. It is a dominant search engine in Korea, and a visit to Naver and you will get a ton of information to start your day. You get the weather forecast, the latest news, most trending products, stock market information, and a ton more. You can say that it is an SEO heaven because it integrates with various user-generated content platforms like blogs and cafes directly into the search. For example, if you search for best shopping malls in Korea, let me translate this to English, and you will get all the popular posts. And if you want to dig deeper into finding out what other blogs say, what other influencers think about your search term, and here are the content that other influencers have created based on your search term. Plus, Naver has a shopping smart blog powered by AI that is composed of product recommendations based on what you have bought, most sought after products during each season, and the most popular products at that time. And you also get to see their live shopping TV. So if you are a business person operating in Korea, then Naver is a necessity for your business to be found. Next on the list is Baidu. It is the largest search engine in China and dominates search within the vast Chinese market. It offers a similar search experience as Google with a clean interface and focuses on relevant results. And much like any other search engines, it adheres to its local internet regulations. A search on how to buy afternoon session tickets to the Forbidden City, Beijing, and it will bring you to the webpage to buy the tickets. This is an ad. This is an ad as well, as you can see here. This is an ad as well as this. And the first organic result is a page where you can book the tickets online. Another search for something like Chinese martial arts school, and it will give you a featured snippet, much like the ones you see on Google. It gives you results from its very own encyclopedia, and you will realize some of Baidu's search engine results comes with an image and gives each search results more visual assets as compared to Google. And you get to choose if you like to search for document formats other than web pages. Baidu is not just a search engine. As you can see, it offers a ton of other services as well, including Baidu Maps that works similar to Google Maps, Baidu Tieba, which is a popular forum for discussions on various topics, Baidu Haokan, which is a search engine for short videos. So if you understand the Chinese language, Baidu may be a good alternative search engine for you. Next, we have Kok Kok. Kok Kok, which is Knock Knock in Vietnamese, is a major search engine in Vietnam. It caters to specific needs of Vietnamese internet users by offering a Vietnamese language interface, prioritizing Vietnamese search results, and integrating local features. These are the features the search engine offers. It provides different search functions for the education category, travel entertainment, which might be helpful to you as a tourist to book flights, hotels and restaurants, information lookup, and they even have an AI chatbot if you install and use the Kok Kok browser. The search engine will prioritize search results with the Vietnamese language. So if you are doing business in Vietnam and you want to be found by the locals and tourists, have a website in the Vietnamese language. It also offers a safe search feature. This is the translated text, so turning this setting on will keep your children safe. And for all the SEOs, there is a search console for you to submit your web pages. So the next time you are visiting Vietnam, you may want to consider using Kok Kok to search for what you need. Next, parents are always worried about kids getting exposed to things that they shouldn't see. So the next popular search engine is Kido. Kido is a safe search engine powered by Google Search, specifically designed for children as it serves age-appropriate search results. It filters out explicit content, violence, and anything unsuitable for younger audiences. And to test if the search engine is truly kid-friendly, let's search for an unfriendly keyword such as where to buy weapons. And we will see some friendly content instead. Seems really friendly. And the thing is, you can search for facts as well. Such as why is Pluto not a planet? And here are some results. On top of that, Kido claims not to collect any personally identifiable information and their logs are deleted every 24 hours. So you can rest easy and leave your kids alone to search freely. But don't leave them alone for too long. They'll do something else with your device. You know what I mean, parents. If you are looking to use search engines for a course, there are a couple of them that allow you to do good while you search, but we find that the most reputable is Ecosia. Ecosia is a search engine with a mission to plant trees through its ad revenue. So every search you make on Ecosia, and every ad you see and click, the money generated from those ads will go towards saving the earth. Ecosia doesn't compile its own massive index of web pages to deliver the search results. They partner with Bing, and with your consent, Google, to provide you with the search results and ads. So if you are not concerned with Bing and Google's privacy issues, why not do your search on Ecosia and save Mother Earth? And on top of being just a traditional search engine, they provide an AI chat feature as well. Just like ChatGPT and Google Gemini, you can simply ask a question and they will provide you with a reply. Most importantly, the reason why we share Ecosia instead of the rest of the charity search engines is that they do not operate behind closed doors. They publish their financial reports monthly so that you have a good idea where the money flows to. And they also provide regular updates on tree planting projects. And speaking about moving away from traditional search engines, here are a couple of AI search engines you may find helpful. Well, the goal of search engines is to provide you with answers, but instead of a search index like the traditional search engines, Perplexity AI leverages on the power of large language models to generate a response. Anyone watching this remembers AskJeeves.com, where their initial idea was to provide users with immediate answers instead of a list of websites? They failed at that because the technology wasn't that advanced. But this can now be accomplished since AI chatbots are introduced. So a search for why was Pluto not a planet but a dwarf planet? Sorry, I misspelled this. And you will see where it gets its sources from, the answers, and all the other related questions together with the videos. On top of that, this is free to use and it can be a powerful tool for research. However, do keep a lookout for the GPT model they are using because older AI models are trained with lesser data points, hence their response may not be that accurate. So always fact check before trusting the response, but for common questions, questions that people always ask, this would definitely do a good job. Another AI search engine on the list is You.com. Just like Perplexity AI, you can ask any questions and it will provide you with immediate answers without you visiting any web pages. For example, a question just popped up in my mind a couple of seconds ago, which was when was the first chocolate bar invented? If we search for this on Google, it says 1847 by Joseph Fry. And if we search for this on You.com, it says 1847 by Joseph Fry as well. And it even provides you with the evolution of chocolate bars as well, because you may be interested to know it. So this is another cool AI search engine you can try. Maybe you will find it helpful. Next on the list is IaaS.ai. Of all the AI search engines mentioned, IaaS.ai is one that resembles the modern Bing and Google the most, as it encompasses AI-produced results together with the traditional list of indexed websites. For example, you can filter your search by a question, academic, and all these other specific functions, and you can choose the length of the AI-generated results. Let's make this concise and ask the question, why was Pluto not a planet but a dwarf planet? I got it right this time. And you will get a very concise answer. It even provides the sources of information. If you scroll down, you will see a list of the most relevant index web pages. So if you are looking for immediate answers from the search engines without using Google or Bing, then IaaS.ai may be a good alternative. Now let's move on to some unconventional search engines, starting with Wayback Machine. Whenever you want to see past references of the web, for example, you know what is ask.com, but if you want to know how its previous version looked, you can search for it. As you can see, it goes way back to 1998, and there are two snapshots in December. If you click on it, you will notice that it was called Ask Jeeves before it was ask.com. So you can basically search for any domains, and it will probably have a snapshot of how the website looked in the past. Some SEOs will do a check on a domain to figure out if a domain has a shady past before they commit their efforts to a domain. Some will use the Wayback Machine for research purposes, or whatever. Wayback Machine is simply a search engine for archives of web pages that ever existed. But do note that it will only take snapshots, so don't expect the functions of the old web pages to work properly. Next in line, we have Search Code. Search Code may be a programmer's heaven because it allows you to search over 75 billion lines of code from over 40 million projects. So whatever projects you are currently working on, there will probably be lines of code or references that will fit your project. Wolfram Alpha is not a typical search engine, but they excel in providing factual answers, computation, and analysis of data. It doesn't crawl and index the web like search engines, but they rely on a vast knowledge base and algorithms. If you need to calculate future value, just search for it, and it will provide you with a tool to do just that. They will also provide you with the equation, an example, together with graphical representations. So the next time you have a mathematical or scientific issue, Wolfram Alpha is a great search engine to solve your problems. If you are a content creator looking for images or audio to be used on your project without any legal issues, you've got to check out Openverse. Simply do a search, and you will find many images and audios you can use. What's helpful is you can filter the contents by their licenses or by its allowable use cases. They have a safe browsing setting as well. So these are the popular search engines we found that are not Google, Bing, or Yahoo. If you have your favorites that are not on the list, do share them with us. Leave a comment down below. We truly appreciate that. If you found this video helpful, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up button. And if you haven't subscribed to us, do so because we are all about sharing SEO knowledge that works. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.